Hello and welcome to Modern Classics, the series in which I take a look at brand new games for my favorite retro platforms, the Commodore 64 and Commodore Amiga. And today we'll be taking a look at Power Glove for the Commodore 64 and Power Glove Reloaded for the Commodore Amiga. Both of these games are published by RGCD and both are available in both physical and downloaded versions. The difference is, Power Glove for the Commodore 64 was released a few years back. Power Glove Reloaded is a remake of sorts for the Commodore Amiga. What's different? Well, Power Glove Reloaded has a bigger map, added boss fights, more items, overall it's a slightly bigger game. But by and large, it is the same game. We'll be taking a look at both the boxes and what's in them, as well as the games themselves. So let's get started with the boxes. Now before we take a look at what's actually in the box, this here is the poster you get along with the Commodore 64 version. RGCD almost always does little perks like this, and most of their games come with a poster of sorts. And for Power Glove, it contains, well, the level map as you can see. But that's not all, it's a two-sided poster. The other side of this poster shows you the, the box art, but then in a nice big version. It's one of the perks of buying, a physical release, and I like that RGCD keeps doing high quality posters like this. Very nice. So now let's see what kind of box you get and what's in it. I got the standard edition of the game, which comes in this cardboard box over here. There's also a deluxe version of the game. I didn't get that, but I do have other deluxe editions from RGCD, so I can show you what kind of box that comes in. Difference being, this is a plastic box and this is a cardboard box, and one is much smaller than the other. Pick what you like. Now, what is actually in this box? Because, well, you bought this with your hard-earned money, it's good to know what you get, right? Well, let's see what Power Glove gives you in the box. It's a neat and tidy package containing one very nice cartridge, instant loading, two stickers of the game and the player and its enemies, and of course a manual. Now the manual is printed and in color, so that is very nice. Overall, I think it's a nice package. Now as you can see, the Amiga version is not left out when it comes to posters, and this one comes with a world map just like the Commodore 64, and it has some extra stuff like what enemies you can find. It's a very nice high quality poster, and like the C64 version, it too has the box art on the reverse, so that is very nice to see. Now compared to the Commodore 64 version of the game, the Amiga version is kind of a different beast. Look at the size of the box you're getting. And for comparison, this is the Commodore 64 version, so the Amiga version comes in a much bigger box. In fact, other than it being plastic, it reminds me very much of the old commercial game releases that you would get on the Amiga. It's really a big box. But it doesn't end there. This Amiga version comes packed with far more goodies than the Commodore 64 version, and it's a lot cheaper to boot. I would call this the ultimate version of the game, really. So let's see what you actually get in the box, in the Power Glove box. To start off, you get the floppy disk of the game. You can order a version without, if you prefer to have just the CD. But look at it, it's a very nice floppy disk. It has a professionally looking label on it. That's very nice. Then you get the CD of the game. And this is an actual pressed CD. None of this CDR business. This is done very professionally. And it has a lovely label on it as well. So look at that, that's nice. This CD contains all sorts of goodies, by the way. It has the game for the Amiga, the PC, Mac, Linux, and C64, as well as the manual and all the posters. So that's really good news. But not all. We also get another label for the floppy, in case you bought the CD version or you want to make another floppy disk copy, which is very nice. You get a lovely looking manual. I'm really happy with this manual. It oozes quality, it's professionally printed. I love it, it's great. you get these two postcards. I'm pretty sure the C64 version also contained a postcard, but I couldn't find mine. You also get these stickers, one from RGCD, the publisher, and one from Lazy Cow, the developer, and you get these here buttons. So all in all, you get a lot of stuff for your money. Yeah, I think this is great. So let's see how these games play next. So here we are with the Commodore 64 version of Power Glove. Now this game is like a light Metroidvania game in which you collect a few objects such as this power glove here, which allows you to shoot, in order to aid you in your quest. And your quest is to find 5 control diamonds that help you to repair a broken down reactor. And that reactor powers, well, all of humanity's electricity, really. So it's really quite important that we go and fix it. Initially, you can choose for 2 of these tubes, and if you find the keys, you can get the last 3 open as well, and you need to go into every single one of these to actually complete the game. So let's get started and see what it's all about. Now, this game, like most Metroidvania games, is not about just randomly rushing in. It rewards patience and paying close attention to your surroundings and the enemies. Every single one of these enemies has its own attack pattern, and you need to learn every one of them. And patience is a virtue, because if I had just run on straight here, I would have been shot by that monster over there. Now, this is a 16 kilobyte game, so there's a lot of repetition in the looks, but it really doesn't matter all that much. It nails the look of one of these underground bases quite well, in my humble opinion, anyway. What also helps is that it really plays very nicely. Collision detection is pretty much spot on. You always know what each and every one of these monsters is gonna do, and if something goes wrong, it's your fault and you know it. The only real downside I've got, and I'm gonna show you that right now, is that you do need to know the layout of the levels, and frankly, you can't always know it. So here, what you want to do is jump down here, but you couldn't see where you were going. This is a blind jump. The game has a couple of those. Be careful here. Yeah, good. And that is a bit of a downer. But other than that, this is actually a really enjoyable game. There's even a few upgrades, so you can get a rocket booster, I think, to let you fly a bit later on in the game. Now, in our quest, there are some upgrades we can get, such as the rocket boots, but also hearts to get us new energy. Be careful here. Other than that, it's just a question of finding all the diamonds. You can see there's a little map in the bottom of the screen, which can be really helpful if you're trying to find out how to get back. Yeah, let's wait for it to open its mouth. It did that now. No! Shush. It's a dangerous road I'm taking here. Well, the game is hard, and that has to do with the care you need to take, but also the leaps of faith, and, well, it doesn't really hold your hand. You get these 4 hearts, and, well, lose them and it's game over, and you get to start straight back from the beginning. So you really do want to be careful a bit. Other than that, it has the standard C64 problem of using up to jump, and these little jumps in the corner there, they're kind of annoying, but other than that, it doesn't control at all poorly. Oh dear, that was more luck than anything. I found a key, which is good. So as you can see, the keys are where you're looking for these keys, so you can open up the other locations that allow you to get more of these control diamonds. It's basically the game in a nutshell. If you consider that this is a game that had to fit in 16 kilobytes, I think that an amazing job was done. It has a lot of good stuff going for it. It has smooth scrolling, smooth animation. That was stupid. But not just that, it also just, well, it plays well, and it feels like a cohesive whole. A lot of games don't have that. Let's see what's over here. I especially enjoy how you can instantly see what's going to happen based on the looks of the enemies. You just know that these are going to go up and down, and that the other guy was going to go jump or walk towards you. Here's a health pickup. They're hidden every now and then, and you do kind of need them. So, we've got a key. Enemies respawn, as you can also see. And what's hard to convey in words is, well, it plays well. I mean, you can get the game and find out for yourself, but it's actually fun, and it is relatively addictive too. I mean, this is not the first time I've been playing it for this video, but I don't mind having to play it several times. It gives me a chance to get a little bit better at it and show you more of the game, and frankly, this game deserves, I think it deserves all the attention it gets. I like it a lot. There we go. Don't hit me. Thank you. Aha. Ha! I got you there. Let's see what's over here. More of these. I really like the design of the monsters, by the way. It has something very, I don't know, console-like to it? Arcade-like? Oh, vision detection glitch there for a sec. I enjoy playing this game a lot, and that's important, which is half the reason why I find it such a good game to begin with. And let's see. Yes. There's nothing up there, by the way. Ooh, another enemy. What are you? Oh, no, 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 go away. Got what they did. I think I know where I am now. This is where you see this is actually a Metroidvania. You can't make that ledge until you get the rocket boots power up. So there are things that you need to progress further, and I like that. You get to go back. I must admit that this game would really have benefited from some sort of continue game option, because as it is, it's not very easy, and perhaps you like that. Personally, I would prefer... Be careful here for a sec. Yeah, I made it. That's good news. Die, robot. Personally, I would have preferred some form of password system or something. I understand why it's not in there. This is a 16 kilobyte game. I mean, come on, what do you expect? But it is slightly on the hard side. That would be my main criticism, is that it is a bit on the hard side, and that has to do, has a lot to do with the invisibility. Right, and there's a slight amount of inertia to your character, which also makes it slightly harder. Don't get me wrong, I really like this game, so don't see this as some sort of, oh, this game is horrible statement. It isn't. It's actually very good. I recommend it wholeheartedly. Where are you gonna shoot? Come on. Shoot, so that I can see where you end up shooting. Yeah. Alright, run. And there we go. That was a lot more luck than wisdom, what happened there. There we go. So now we've played the first, well, most of the first area, and we can go on and look at the second area or one of the later areas. Now, I'm just going to pick the last area at random. I'm sure this is not going to end well, but I just want to show you that you can actually choose whatever, oh dear, whatever location you want to go once you get a key. So you don't have to run through the game in the same order over and over again. And let's be careful. I don't know these enemies very well. Okay, I managed to stop them. That's good. What are you doing? You're gonna drop on me, aren't you? Yeah. Okay. I've got a hunch that something might be up there, but it's possible that I may... It's entirely possible that what I did made my life harder right? I don't know what the proper order is to play this game in. So that's one thing you have to find out for yourself. And... oh, there's actually locked sub... that's interesting. So I can't go in there. Oh, that was so much luck. I didn't intend to drop down there, but I did. Wait, I don't think I can go anywhere from here. Alright, so I got myself stuck here, which is not good. Can I go? Oh, I need to go here. No, 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 go away. My cat is trying to play along. I love my cat, but it's not very useful when he starts to add himself into the microphone business. So we're nearly game over. Let's see if we can't get a little bit further yet. What's over here? What's this? I need to drop my... oh dear, I've got no weapon now. That's no good. I'm not sure this was a wise idea. Nope. I made a terrible mistake here. I think this is game over for me. Yes, it is. Oh well. Well, that gives me time to look at the other version of the game, the Amiga version. So I'll be right back with that. Hold on. And here we are with the much nicer looking Amiga version of Power Glove. Power Glove Reloaded. It's very similar, but there are some key differences which we'll be going over. First and foremost, and you can see that straight away, is that we have 6 rather than 5 levels to choose from, so we've got an additional level. Other than that, this game also supports 2 buttons and looks and sounds nicer. There's a little bit of an Easter egg over here. You can go and have a look at the Intex terminal, which is kind of funny. Which just so happens to have exactly 38 kilobytes of memory free. How odd. And it tells us how far we are along in fixing up the reactor. But let's get started by looking at the game itself then. By the way, there's another room that wasn't there on the C64. This appears to be completely empty. Perhaps it has some secret hidden meaning, but I haven't found it yet. With that said, let's get started. The level layout is ever so slightly different, and there are more things to pick up. It's a bit more of a Metroidvania. But look at those graphics. I mean, it might just be me, but I think this game looks great. The C64 version looked nice enough, but this looks wonderful. This looks like a commercial release from back in the day. Or better in some places. So it's a very nice looking game. And what immediately becomes very apparent is that it plays very similar to the C64 version. This is not a coincidence, because the game was meant to be was designed in such a way it made portability easier. This is just an enhanced version then of the original. Oh dear, that was incredibly lucky. Where? Let's chalk that up to me being very good at the game and continue. So some of the screens are different, as you might notice here. But there's more to it than just a little bit of screen differences. Be careful though. Yes. You see, there's also, oh dear, at least one more pickup. Power shot, which lets you shoot through certain bricks, which is not in the C64 version. But there's one big change, and maybe I will manage to show that, and that is bosses. Let's see if I... oh, come on. Yeah. Let's destroy them. And
Let's go. Come on. Thank you. First, we need to pick up that health power-up we had seen on the C64, because we actually lost some health, and these boss fights, they are not easy. They're the main difference in the gameplay. And I think they're a nice addition, but they do make that statement I made earlier about the game being on the difficult side bigger. It's a very nice game, but it really could use some form of continue system. It's slightly on the long side for doing it in one sitting, and it just is very annoying to lose every bit of progress when you're that far along. Also notice that the respawn here is different. And there we go. So if I go back a screen, you'll notice that the respawn isn't always the same as on the C64, where you got the same enemies respawning in over and over. Not so much on the Amiga version, where what you get depends a great deal on if you kill all the enemies or not. If you kill all the enemies in a room, then what respawns is different than what was there before. Let's see what's over here. Okay, we don't need health, so we'll leave that there. And the jumps also seem slightly easier in places, and that's as I miss one, obviously. What I mean by that is the jumps, like the one in the corner down there in the left. That's right, yes. Down in the right corner there. They're easier to do on the Amiga. I don't know why, but it is very notable. Let's see if I can do this better. That went more like how I wanted it to go. Okay, now this is the boss fight, so we're gonna see how good I am. If I don't say much, that's because it's rather difficult. Oh god. There we go. Die! Okay. No. You only get 4 hit points, and that really means you gotta be careful. This looked a lot easier than it was, by the way. I needed to do this boss fight 4 or 5 times the first time I played. Oh dear, Europe is now out of power. So this is one of the additions, the boss fights and a little bit more story. I like it. It adds to the game. And you get a little bit of extra health. And now we've got the key. Which is great news. Bosses don't seem to respawn, which is probably for the best. Now we're gonna go and make our way back up and see if we can't. Get a bit further. I'll show a different area because we've seen the first and fifth area on the Commodore 64 for a bit. So. No, that was stupid. I'll go get health. I'm so close to a health pickup, it would be silly not to pick it up. And there we go. Extra health. I like the samples. Actually, I like a lot about this game. I'm a little bit critical about the difficulty, perhaps, but other than that. And that's not even because I'm opposed to difficult games. It's more that this is the kind of difficulty that... that was stupid. That is kind of dependent on you remembering things. And I don't always like that design, right? You progress by remembering where you were. It can work, and trust me, this game makes a good case for it. Okay, we gotta get a long way around here. But if I had to put a point out a drawback, that's it. Right, look at it like that. This isn't me saying the game is bad, this is me saying, well, if you want to know what I personally think is the weakest part of the game, it's that. Everything else, I really liked. It controls well. When you do get damage, it's almost always very clearly your fault. Well, the exception there being if you run into a new kind of enemy you didn't know before, or if you jump into one of those leaps of faith. But other than that, it really is a very well-designed game. You can feel, it's a bit subjective obviously, but you can feel that a lot of effort has gone into making it play well. And I like that a lot. Let's see. This is the same place we were in the C64 version. You can't get this either. You still need to get the boots that I don't have. Oh, I don't remember this on the C64 version. Let's have a peek. Ooh. Careful now. Like I said, this game rewards you taking care. And thank you. So that's that. Also like how it has different musical tracks for each of the different environments. Ooh, another health pickup. That's good, because we lost a hit point. Well, let's see if we can't get to, should we do? I might try out level 3. That might not be a bad idea. Yeah, let's go for level 3. But until we get there, I really enjoy that this game is out though, because you see, there's a lot of stuff out for the Commodore 64, right? The Commodore 64 has a ton of homebrew out for it. The Amiga had a lot less, but it's finally starting. This is part of it, and I think it's great. Oh, let's not do that. To see my favorite retro platform getting some action. Ah, this is where you need the power shot, the extra power up that, well, you need to fetch, really. And we don't have it yet. We probably won't get it either. Now let's see if I can't do this. Oh dear, I did it right in one go. These jumps are surprisingly hard from time to time. No, 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 don't. Careful. Don't want to run into... You do get careful in this game. That's probably a good thing. Fits what the game is trying to achieve. There we go. Shoot again, please. Thank you. And we're off to level 3. Well, nearly anyway. Oh dear. And I managed to lose yet another hit point. It's so easy to lose hit points in this game. So, level 3. Not 4, 3. And it looks completely different. Oh, I didn't intend to do that. And I immediately jump into an enemy. Right. I like this. Careful. One of the... Hello. One of the good things is that your gun has a lot more range than the enemy, which makes your life easier, because they need to see you before they start shooting, and they don't always see you. Whoa! Luckily, a health pack, which doesn't restore all your health, it just gives you 2 hit points back. Ooh, that was more luck than anything else. But I really like this game. It's filled with character, really. Let's try this one. And let's go here. Come on. No, that was not very smart. We're gonna do this the safe way. Oh, come on. Thank you. There we go. Let's see where we are. Careful now. See, that's a good thing to do. You're gonna shoot that way now, aren't you? No! Ah! There you go. Dead. Let's try this room. Let's not go up yet. This is a boss fight. Oh dear. Oh, I died. Oh well. So in a nutshell, what do I think of Power Glove? I think it's actually a really, really nice game. And like I said, I'm very happy that there is an Amiga game out there now that is, well, quite good and homebrew. So I'm hoping for more of these. I know there are a couple of others that I missed, so I'm going to be taking a look at those as well. I might feature them in video, I might not. We'll see. But this game is... Well, I wouldn't call it an immediate classic, but it's really a very nice game for what it is, and I highly recommend you having a look at it. I also wrote about this on my website, so you can go and have a look over on there. I put the link in the description below, and I'll put a link to RGCD where you can get the game as well, so that you can go and have a peek at it. There's also a digital-only version, which is on itch.io, and I'll put a link to that in the description as well. Regardless of what version you get, the C64 or the Amiga version, this is a good game. If I had to choose, I would get the Amiga version because, well, you get the C64 version as well. But it's hard to beat the aspects of a real physical cartridge. So you gotta make a choice there. With that in mind, this concludes our little look at Power Glove for the Amiga. I hope you enjoyed it.